Well, so Tyler Toffoli, you know, he decided to stay in Southern California and train in the offseason, and we're staying in SoCal, Odie. Some nice little perks with that, isn't there?
It really is. As long as you're working hard, you can do that kind of stuff. What's that saying about all work and no play makes for...
A very tall boy.
There you go.
He is not one of those. Listen, Tyler Toffoli has to play into the fact that Milan Lucic was unable to sign with the LA Kings. He gets 7 years to go to Edmonton and a whole lot of money. The Kings couldn't afford to do that and then re-sign a Tyler Toffoli.
No, they couldn't. I mean, they probably could afford to have Milan re-sign for this year. But then you start to look at Toffoli coming up. You look at McNabb coming up. You look at Pearson coming up. Those guys are going to get some raise, especially Toffoli. We know he's going to get, if you look at the comparables, he's going to get a fairly good raise after next year. And that's where the contract long-term didn't make sense for the Kings.
How do you evaluate one season with Lucic, and also what impact will it have not having that physical style of forward with the team?
Well, I think regular season was a success, and I thought he played well in the playoffs. But you have to look, how did the team do? And I think just the investment they had to make, and look, he deserves it. He got a 7-year deal from Edmonton. You play long enough, you get what you can get. So he deserves that deal. It's just, I think the Kings made the right decision walking away, not because he's not a great player, but just the effect, the cuts they would have had to make down the road, I think were too steep to commit to that kind of long-term deal.
One of those cuts is Trevor Lewis. Now the Kings were able to give him a 4-year contract, and he's always that unsung hero on this team. It's a good signing for LA.
I think it is. He really is. He's a glue guy. He's a guy that's been here with the Kings for a long time, plays center, plays right wing, and you look, scored a couple goals in the playoffs. He's one of those guys that's just, you don't notice him, but if you really watch him for a game and watch what he does, this guy gives everything he has on every shift. Coaches love him, the players love him, he's versatile. He can play wing, he can play center, and he's a king. I mean, he's everything that you embody in what an LA King is Trevor Lewis, and he's a guy you wouldn't be able to have. So would you like to have Lucic here long term? Yes, but I think the cost of not only some of those guys that are coming up, but the supporting guys you wouldn't be able to get. Trevor Lewis, a perfect example. He's able to come back now.
Yeah, I think it's also great just to hang on to the guys that were such a huge part of those cup victories. And Trevor Lewis is that. Braden McNabb also got himself a contract. The Kings really like his play and how he's developing. You agree?
I think it's a great deal for both teams. It's a 2-year deal, kind of they call them bridge deals now. We're not really sure what Braden McNabb is right now. He played with Drew Doughty, played well. Then he got bumped down to the 5 and 6 role when someone else would play with Drew. So I know the Kings are looking for Braden to take that baton and kind of play more and become a top 4 guy. This gives him 2 years to kind of find his way, do that, and then he'll get that big deal after that. But I think it was a great deal for the Kings and a great deal for Braden.
Well, the salary cap this year has gone up a little bit, right, to $73 million, but the Kings are basically right at that number. They were able to sign some players, all 1-year contracts, and Teddy Purcell has returned to the LA Kings. Now, he was originally drafted by LA in 2007, traded to Tampa in 2010. Great to have him back. Michael Lotta, also a 1-year contract. He's 25, has spent 3 seasons all with the Capitals. Patrick Bjorkstrand, 1-year entry-level contract. He's 24, has been playing in the KHL. Tom Gilbert, unrestricted defenseman signing, 1-year contract. He's 33, but a right-handed shot can play some power play, and he's definitely very, very good puck mover. Zach Trotman, a young defenseman, 25 years old, 3 seasons in the NHL, all with Boston. Played with Boston last year, 38 games. But Teddy Purcell, Sean, listen, this is a great guy, and he returns. It's not Milan Lucic, that physical style of play, but he certainly could chip in. And he played with Andrei Kopitar before and was successful.
He really was, and I like these moves by the Kings. Teddy Purcell is the one that I like the most, but all 5 of the guys you just mentioned, 1-year deals, which I think really gives the Kings a lot of flexibility after this year, because with that cap, you never know where it's going. But Teddy Purcell, I played with him in L.A. He was traded at the deadline in 2010, but that versatility that we talk about, he can play the wing on any of the top or any of the 4 lines, almost like Christopher Stieg was able to come in. I think it would be a real good fit with the Kings last year. You know, Pittsburgh Penguins won the Stanley Cup last year. It wasn't the first line that won. It wasn't the second line. It was that third line with Bonino, Hagelin, and Kessel. So if you can get a guy like Teddy Purcell, who scored 20 goals a couple times in the league, maybe he's a first line guy. Maybe he's a second line. But if he is a third line guy, to be able to have that kind of talent, that kind of sniper on that bottom line, it just gives you so much more versatility. So I think an excellent pickup by the Kings.
Okay, Odie, let's talk about the goaltending situation as far as who's going to back up Jonathan Quick this year. Enroth has moved on. We got Jeff Zadkoff, who just won a Stanley Cup with the Penguins. He's a former LA King, and also the Kings made the one trade, and that's acquiring Jack Campbell from Dallas. So what are your thoughts, and who do you think is going to be the man to back up Quick?
Well, I think what's nice about this year is that there's going to be a competition for the backup. We know who the starter is going to be. And the last couple of years, we've known who the backup's going to be. But this year, with Zatkov, who played for Pittsburgh the first two games of the playoffs this year, Campbell, a former first rounder. And with goalies, you never know. Most players with 20, 21, 22, you know what you have. Sometimes with the goalies, 25, 26, even 27, until you really figure out what you have with the goalie. And let's not forget Peter Budaj. Played in Ontario last year, played in the NHL a whole bunch, was goalie of the year last year in the American League. So there's three guys right now that are going to be legitimately competing for that backup job with John McQuarrie.
Yeah, I mean, you also look at, listen, the Ontario Reign is a very good team to have them there. And so whether it's Budaj, who's going to have to clear waivers right after training camp, and Jack Campbell, maybe that's – and Dean Lombardi said it's been frustrating for him to develop guys like Bernier and Jones and just to lose him, but that's kind of part of the business.
It really is when you have a stud like Jonathan Quick and you get these guys. Remember Jonathan Quick when he came in? Bernier was supposed to be the guy that was going to be the future. Jonathan Quick just – played better than he did, so they were able to move him to Toronto. And Martin Jones is the other guy, wasn't drafted. The Kings did a great job developing him, and then he was part of that trade for Lucic to Boston. They ended up flipping him to San Jose, but you look at those two examples of Bernier and Jones, they're gone. Now the system is flush with goalies again.
Well, the Kings have lost some top picks over the years, so they go into this draft as VP of Hockey Operations for the Kings. Mike Fuda said, we just had to take our medicine. So they took their medicine, they got four players, what'd they get?
Well, if you look at what they did, they took three defensemen and one forward. I think they identified the goaltending situation. They made a trade on draft day for Campbell, which was a goalie, and they took three defensemen. So I think they're trying to, you know, the Kings always talk about starting in the back end and moving out as far as stocking the system. So you got three young guys. I think they did a good job with draft picks. They're 18 years old. You're not going to be able to tell really for 3 or 4 years and give them a grade on how they did. But I think they certainly took a step in the right direction of filling that pot again. In the minor league system and in the system.
Kings appear to be Team Jacob and also Kale. I mean, that's a perfect pick for LA, right? But a great upside, it appears. Maybe he drops, so that's a good value pick at that slot.
I think it was. I think he's a guy that has a ton of talent on the back end. You look at what the Kings want in their defensemen. They usually finish hard. They're heavy. Drew Doughty, obviously, is a special kind of player. But this is the kind of guy, he's not a bigger guy, so he's going to have to put on some muscle. But, I mean, this kid can skate all day. He's got great hockey IQ. Just has to learn some things, as they all do at that age. But I think with the Kings, the things that he can do naturally with the skating ability and some of the things he does on the ice as reads, I think the Kings got a great pick in the second round.
Probably can't wait for training camp. Be a little starstruck with some of these Kings, and Drew Doughty in particular. That should be fun for those young players. When we return on this Kings Live offseason special, a changing of the guard, a changing of the sea. Stick with us. That is next.